sprites are keeping him alive, and they keep going in deeper. They come in and now lose a beam stuns. They're going in deeper, Alliance. All the heroes are pulled. Cloud9 after a second failed buyback attempt to hold the Roshan, lose the game to Alliance.
Live from the Monster Energy DreamHack Studios, welcome to the ASUS ROG Dreamleague Season 2, where amazing happens. I'm Bruno, your host, and with me is James and Andy. Guys, how's it going?
You didn't do the voice.
I know.
So it's been live.
I don't know how to do this voice.
That's good enough.
Okay.
And you said voice, which makes it even cooler.
How are you?
I'm alright. I'm just talking shit to Team Tinker. apparently, Bulba winks at waitresses. I'm getting info.
Yeah.
Have you ever met Sam? That's what he
Sam
does.
Sam does a lot of interesting
There's only two things.
Things
that he does. He flirts with girls, and he walks up from behind you no matter where
wait,
you
wait,
are.
Wait. He has a girlfriend, dude.
What?
He has a girlfriend.
Does he?
Yeah, he has. So, no, he doesn't flirt with girls anymore.
Okay.
Aside from his girlfriend, of course.
Do you still flirt with your girlfriend, though?
You kind of have to keep things fresh.
Okay.
You know?
That's fair.
Yeah. I mean, so we have today region Europe West starting. There's four teams, four ASC, which I didn't know. Did you know what it meant?
I have no idea what it meant, but I just know it's Trixie's team.
Four anchors and a sea captain, apparently.
Ah, so is Trixie the captain then?
Yeah, I guess. Maybe Jerax.
Are they all Finnish?
Yes, they're all Finnish. Okay. It's a Finn stack. We also have Alliance, Fnatic, and Team Tinker. Unfortunately, I don't know exactly. Shit happened. Again, that's the best way to put it. And,
Drama League. It's better than reality TV, yeah. The Dream League.
So let's keep up with the Kardashians, okay? So Alliance cannot play today. And they were supposed to play, I think, for ASC. Right. And because they cannot play, that match will be rescheduled at a later date. Unfortunately, we tried to make the admins force Alliance to drop out of Synergy League to make things equal. That didn't fly. We tried. We'll hopefully have something happening by then. Today we only have one game then, which is why
we have two games.
Well, no, we have one
matchup.
Matchup. That's the word, exactly. And the matchup was going to be Team Tinker versus Fnatic. Fnatic being Honey, Rise, Come With Me, that new team that they haven't been performing really well. They have a chance in the Dream League to make it maybe take
dreams
a couple
come
games.
True in the Dream League.
I know. Not all of their dreams, but for some people, some nightmares as well.
To add to your reality TV, we killed Lumi from the series. He wasn't bringing in the ratings.
No.
But we're going to bring him back as a zombie. Spoiler. Just to add to the reality TV.
A little bit of Walking Dead never
hurts. Yeah. It's what's popular these days.
Halloween season.
Sometimes I kind of wish I was dead, you know? true.
You're not the only one. But so today we're going to jump straight into the games. We're not talking much about everything because I think the games need to start. Let me know when they start because I don't see the previous screens.
I don't know if they're waiting on us because we've had a full lobby for a while. So
I mean, if we're going to start, they're going to start. But for ASC, let me tell you, these were the guys that beat Team Secret twice in the qualifiers. They beat them in the winner's bracket, went all the way to the finals of the winner's bracket. They lost to Team Tinker. Team Tinker was the first team to qualify. And for AFC, again, fought against Team Secret on the loser bracket. And they won 2-0. And it was a massacre. It was like not even close like the EG Secret final from yesterday, Star Ladder. No, it was just like completely destroyed in all lanes. Outplayed, outdrafted. So I'm really looking forward to see this team, which, I mean, it's a new team, but has a lot of old faces. Trixie, Jerax, famous for the amazing Cupid Red Pandas.
And Earth Spirit Spam.
And Earth Spirit Spam.
I'm missing Nyx Vendettas.
Yes.
That was, no, actually, he didn't even use them, right?
No, he canceled them on the animation to go into a stun, but they hadn't had hit.
Yeah.
It was weird.
Yeah, and then he missed the impales. But he did that. Also, Boogie, one of the
Ninja
guys.
Boogie.
No, not Ninja Boogie. Boogie with Boogie.
Of course.
One of the guys that has been playing actually Dota since 2011. They had a team called Problem that was a very, very old team with Finstax as well. It's an interesting team there. But on the other side, we have Fnatic, which is not an interesting team. I don't know. Maybe it is.
That's some just like open flame. Just like,
maybe that's what makes them interesting. Is that they're not.
Entertaining
stream, least entertaining team.
I don't know, dude. Like, they're not come with me. He's interesting.
Yeah, I know they have
Arise
is cool. Ace crit.
Yeah.
What is it with people going mid and only playing Meg?
Well,
I'm down with.
It's a really good hero.
Wasn't it like Eight Mother and Arise both are standing in and both only play Meg?
Yeah. And then there was Mag. That played Centaur.
Who played Centaur.
Unfortunately.
Game's already in ban and pick, by the way.
Okay, that's great. So without further ado, we're going to go to the games. Prediction for the first game. Like, these teams haven't played each other in quite a while. They probably know each other by a little bit. For ASC or Fnatic, your call.
You don't ultimately get to decide, though. It's not like your call.
Isn't it Team Tinker?
You don't control. This isn't...
It's Team Tinker.
Yeah, it's not what he said.
Whatever he said is wrong.
I know, right? It's not Fnatic, it's Team Tinker. That's even better. That's why I was setting up with not interesting. Team Tinker is much more.
Can we go to the fucking game?
Can I just go home?
Let's go to the game. I'm sitting down. This is my sitting seat. My hair is awesome today because I showered last night. And
you also look really tan in that previous screen.
Alcohol brings up the redness in my face. It does.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. So anyways. It is Team Tinker, which came 5th/6th on Star Ladder this weekend.
Please tell us more.
They were 5th, right?
What?
They were 5th.
5th/6th, it's the same.
Oh yeah, it's the same. Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to the draft. And the draft starts with Legion Commander and Wisp being banned for Fnatic, and Timurino, Tinkerino, Magnus, and Death Prophet.
I mean, the Mag Death Prophet bans kind of make all the sense in the world, just because those are like the very five-man centric. If you feel like you're better than a team, I feel like you ban those heroes, you know?
Yeah.
Like, if you feel like you think you should win, you ban Mag and Death Prophet, because those are two, maybe Mag a little bit less so, but Death Prophet's one of those heroes that I feel has a very high success rate, even though she's vulnerable in the laning phase.
Would you put her like Razor level? Or more above?
I think she's actually above Razor, like in terms of her team fight potential when you start grouping up as five.
Right.
I think Razor is much
Razor
better, obviously, in lanes.
A lot more throughout the game in terms of just like when there's no ulti available because the Razor static link. But as soon as Death Prophet pops, it has exorcism. It's like you can't fight into that as you could fight into
10 seconds to go.
Razor.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. No, I agree.
I agree with you. It's like basically it's that just much more situational. You get Roches with it. You get towers with it. You know, Death Prophet's awesome.
Reserved.
And I like the opening too from Team Tinker as well. Because not only do you get a really strong mid and control hero, who is also very good against Tidehunter in general.
Wait, start that sentence again.
Radiant's ban.
No, I said I really like the opening too from Team Tinker.
Oh, okay. Yeah, like no, I didn't hear that.
They picked Brew and Sky, and I mean, together, obviously, people are kind of, I wouldn't say skipping over Doom a lot, but you don't see him nearly as much as you used to, at least in 6.81, for obvious reasons. But when you take Skywrath away, you open your lanes up a lot more to be able to play whatever kind of style you want. And I think Brew fits in a lot of team compositions right now.
Five seconds.
So whatever strategy you want to play, you can still do it around these two heroes.
Yeah.
Although, I mean, to be fair, we've seen a lot recently how the 682C patch on Brewmaster, the time it takes to actually execute your ultimate has been cancelled a lot more than before.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's something that you cannot just, like, go, Radiant blink, man. Clap, ult, and pretend, like, you're not going to get stunned. So.
Actually, I want to say S4 got his ulti cancelled a few times in the finals against DG.
Very, very, like, yeah, at least three. So, but they don't have the perfect person to cancel that, which is Skyrath Mage. They do have the Ogre Magi, which has an instant... it's not projectile speed.
Yeah. It's just cast animation.
It's just cast animation.
But I think once you get your arms certain way up on Brewmaster, you can't cancel it from there on out.
Because reserved.
Yeah. Once the animation starts to go through,
it's 0.8 seconds. It's almost 1 second. It's quite a lot.
Because I try and do it on Silencer all the time, not to bring up Silencer.
Dire's Bane.
It's quite a good hero. You guys should check him out. But you can notice it's like if your arms are down, you can cancel it. If your arms are up, you
can't. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So
it's like Lina's auto attacks. If you see your hand go up in the air, you're getting hit. Like, it doesn't matter if you're in the well, you're taking damage.
Yeah, and the bans come from Medusa and Necrophos. Andy, you were talking about the counter to Necrophos in the trip today. Every team is will catch
Husker,
up.
Man.
Husker is
super legit. And I actually like Husker against the kind of style that Team Tinker is picking right now. Viper, not so much, because Viper's still Nether Toxin is physical damage, whereas everything else is magic, and plus being slowed a lot. I mean, even if you're magic immune, more or less, in terms of damage taken when you're low HP, it doesn't matter, you're still a snail. The other thing is against Brewmaster, there's already one target that you want to pretty much put in the air all the time, and that's going to be Tide. So Husker probably would have a pretty good reign in the fight. Obviously, I don't think Fnatic are going to pick it, because nobody really picks Husker. No. Old Fnatic picked Husker.
Yeah, they do.
And they
remember that.
They won
Fnatic
with it.
Yeah, they were against a PA.
Because Loda died three times in a row.
Well, he also auto-attacked a creep after...
A creep and a crit.
But that's because auto-attack after spell, I think, is why.
And then we got fixed.
Yeah, that was so unfortunate. But the Centaur and the Doomban coming out as well.
I like
the
Doomban, because when you have a Tide Hunter, that's like, again...
Even though you say you're going to like put the Tide in the air, the reality of that actually happening in the late game when Tide gets blink is just like...
It's hard.
It's like, it's, you know, not easy. I wouldn't fancy my chances. So we'll see what Fnatic are going to do. But if Fnatic have Tide as initiate or counter-initiate, Brewmaster is the main initiator for Team Tinker. So it'd be interesting to see if they're going to pick something else to actually kind of follow up the brew, because it's important that when the brew split goes off, you're able to hold people in place, and they can't do that right now. The Centaur is a good hero for it, just being able to stampede and help out with the rest of the team, get them on top. But they don't have something in terms of locking in place, and that's because the Tidehunter's gone. And it's like, even if you're going to go for a Sand King, that could maybe work for Team Tinker, because it works well with the Skywrath Mage in terms of being able to roam, but it's almost like
10 seconds
Sand King isn't ultimately reliable, because if you can run away from the Blue Master split or fight it on your terms, Sand King doesn't necessarily get his EP or stuns as he would like. So I'm interested to see what Team Tinker do to actually kind of synergize and be able to lock this team down so they can use their Viper, use their Skywrath, and use their Brewmaster properly.
Yeah, it is tricky as well for Team Tinker, because as you said, like, you want something for the Brewmaster, but your only picks remaining are a support and a carry. There are not many carries that offer like that kind of, lock people down.
But you're also thinking of it in a very one-dimensional way. If you look at what Fnatic have right now, they basically have good counter initiation, more or less. Like, they have Tide, Ogre, and Visage. You have good positioning on the birds. They're actually going to decide to go with Witch Doctor, which is, I would say, the more aggressive of choices, and the coconut is strong, right? Mm-hmm. It's good. And plus, you don't want to give it to Fnatic, because we've seen farming Ogre before, not saying that's what they would have done, but it's really strong against Brew Split. I was actually thinking they might go the way of Jakiro, just because if you think about a Brew Split and Viper slow sieging a tower, Skyrath range, and then you have a Jakiro, it's very easy to walk up to a tower and just claim it. You know?
Right. Yeah.
And there's a really large area of, like, you can't necessarily cross it if Team Tinker, or if you don't want to take a team fight. So
Radiance.
And they're actually going to go ahead and remove the Lycan, which I like a lot, because Lycan actually destroys pretty much every hero on their team.
Yep. And Fnatic goes up to pick the Puck. And right now, you can say that the Visage Bears do some damage, but they don't have a very strong lineup in terms of late game damage.
10 seconds to go.
Yep. Whatever they do decide to pick right now, Fnatic, this is going to be pretty much a 4 protect 1 kind of lineup. And the interesting thing about these kind of lineups right now in this patch is that you create so much farm for a person that if it's a tanky hero and it can survive team fight, it's going to be okay. But otherwise, and wow, it's a lone druid. Otherwise, if this hero dies, it's going to give so much to the other team if they're behind that it's really hard to keep ahead.
Well, this Team Tinker's final pick, Lone Druid, actually kind of, this is another way you can play with a Brewmaster. If you get ahead, Brewmaster can actually, if you're like, you know, in terms of their what their team actually has, Brewmaster can actually just force people away from the tower.
Yeah.
If you get a good mid lane and you know get your level 11, you don't even need Axe, you know, just like lads is fine and stuff like that. So you can actually just use the Brewmaster to create enough space that your Lone Druid can go ham on towers, and then attacking through a bear with that lineup, kind of difficult.
Time.
It's not fun.
Yeah, I thought if they were going to go for like the Lone Druid style, Jakiro might have fit their lineup a bit better. But
Than who?
Than the Witch Doctor.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I still like Skywrath because Skywrath opens up the opportunity to pretty much gank any lane. I mean, hell, a Brewmaster Skywrath gank in itself is still kind of scary. But with Fnatic putting the Puck mid, probably a lesser chance of success. And the other thing is, too, I'm assuming the Lone Druid's going to be solo lane, and it's probably going to mean that the Brewmaster's going to be mid and Viper safe lane farms with dual roaming.
Well, and speaking of 4 Protect 1, that is one to protect right now. The Terrorblade is going to be huge right here.
I mean, the Puck's going to have to really perform well here for Fnatic because this is a big hero when it comes to shutting down the push with the Lone Druid, because it's not the Lone Druid that you're actually meant to like look to kill. You're meant to just like take, you know, get a good silence on the Skywrath Mage, the Witch Doctor, and just do a huge amount of damage so that when the rest of your team come in, you know, they don't have the support against the Visage, you know, birds, and you can actually just go ham. So I think the Puck is the going to have to be the playmaker here for Fnatic. And
yeah, but it's so hard. I mean,
yeah, it's not going to be fun. I mean, it's not.
The problem
if you find yourself without Yule's blink, you know, even if you have a blink, it's like the amount of damage you'll take from Pycat or Sing Sing, or you know, anybody with a silence as well on the Skywrath. It's maybe
5 seconds.
Yeah, I actually think it could be too much for the Puck to handle that lineup, especially against EGM Skywrath.
Don't forget that both Puck and Tidehunter are really good against heroes that don't go BKB, and Teen Tinker, of course, two supports. Lone Druid is not a hero that normally goes BKB until way, way late into the game, and maybe it's just for the bear. And even Brewmaster and Viper will not necessarily rush a BKB. Viper maybe, but it's just like two very strong controlling support ultimates that can give the Fnatic the advantage, and just the time that Terrorblade needs to mow down and kill the most important hero at that point in the game and just course through.
I don't know, I feel like all in all, like Team Tinker, in my opinion, has a slightly better draft.
I think they have a way better draft.
I don't know if it's way better, but I think it's definitely better in the laning phase for sure. When they start 5-manning, I think that's when it's really going to be up to Fnatic to try to actually make something happen. Because if you look at Team Tinker, again, they're still kind of lacking initiation. Sing's going to get blink, which is going to be their go, but that's all they have.
But they
much.
Don't need initiation so much, because it's like, as long as they get good laning phases, I'm pretty sure that Lone Druid with the Brewmaster will be able to do what they want, and I don't think the Puck is a big enough answer. I think, yeah, you have Puck and you're going to have Tidehunter, you know, come online later as well, but I would be really scared as that Puck to throw down any kind of like aggressive initiation against a Skywrath, against a Viper, you know, against a Lone Druid. It's just like,
well, that's just it. It's a waiting game for Fnatic. They're waiting for Team Tinker to play into them. That's the style of team that they've picked. Because between Ogre and Visage, you have a little bit of damage that you can throw out, but your range of initiation is pretty small. So you have to wait for Team Tinker to commit to like a tower push or go for Roshan or something like that.
But the thing is that I think Team Tinker will probably be able to stand strong under the towers without having to dive. And I'm expecting Team Tinker to make this map pretty small.
Yeah, no, I agree.
Like, and then basically the Terrorblade falls off unless the Terrorblade has a really nice, you know, time. But the good thing about the Terrorblade in the Fnatic lineup is the Ogre and Visage, two fantastic supports at protecting anybody. It's like, if you want to kill somebody through an Ogre and Visage, it's like, there is no kill unless you get the first kind of initial kill on who you're trying to kill, who you're trying to get, which is going to be the Terrorblade. So if you don't take down the Terrorblade, you know, you're not going to get the Ogre and Visage and you'll probably die, just because of how tanky and how much damage they can do. So
I have a question for you too. Once we get later into the game, individually, which hero do you think is scarier? Lone Druid, with the potential of going for 12 slot, or a Terrorblade, which is one of those heroes that's scarier?
Terrorblade by a large margin.
Yeah, but I think the game, for Team Tinker, they wanted to end way before that.
No, for sure. I mean, Team Tinker could end the game, or high ground, at like 25 minutes, if their early game goes well. But The other problem that they're going to have is their high ground hero basically consists of Lone Druid and I guess Viper a little bit. And then, like James said, they're going to have Sing to, like, if he sees an opportunity, he can jump and zone them off the tower with Split.
And then, but even if Fnatic get a good counter initiation, what's there to actually stop the, you know, how much time will you get off on your Witch Doctor ultimate? Because that's going to be another factor as well. It's like you're going to have to Visage Bird Stun him. Or you're going to have to hit him in the Ravage.
Yeah.
But he won't be throwing his ultimate until the Ravage is probably gone. You know, I would feel very comfortable allowing my team, who's a very tanky Viper, you know, Brewmaster and Lone Druid, to eat a Ravage and then just drop it afterwards. And then it's, you know, it's really the Visage come with me who's playing that.
Well, I mean, it's pretty much, I think it's more the Ogre Magi, which is a tanky hero that can, even early into the game, tank some hit of the Witch Doctor War and try to get close to that Witch Doctor to cancel as well. Because birds are not that reliable once you get one to 1 point.
I mean, they're a pain in the ass to kill.
I mean, if you get an entangle or a clap, you should land your bird stun, like, pretty easily. So I still feel like Team Tinker's draft is better, but I can see the potential of what Fnatic have. Terrorblade late game is still pretty darn scary. And a Viper, even like Viper Lone Druid, I think, if you're talking like in terms of dual core versus a Terrorblade, with Bloodlust and a Ravage on this team, I would still say that there is potential for that to work as long as they're not just out of the game in the first like 20 to 25 minutes.
So
that's going
to
be the true test.
So if you had to say who's going to take this just off lineups, what would
I'd say Tinker.
And what kind of percentage would you give
me? I'm not going there. It's too soon.
I would give 70, 70, 30.
70, 30.
I'd say 60, 40.
For Tinker still, I'm guessing.
For Tinker still, yeah. I mean, if it gets very late into the game, it's kind of scary.
If the whole start of the game goes tits up, right, and the Ogre Magi and Visage actually get, like, these kind of traits into their favor, it could go very differently if the Visage gets a level 6 early and, you know, because that he's a big hero when it comes to defense and damage output. So, and that can create enough room that you don't actually need to bring Hanny on his Terrorblade. But if that doesn't happen and things go just averagely for both teams, Terrorblade's going to take a little bit too long compared to this Lone Druid. Mm-hmm. Who's playing the Lone Druid, actually?
I think it's Quite Clear,
yeah. Question for you, Andy. We haven't seen much Lone Druid recently in the competitive scene.
Sure.
It's not a hero that you pick right now. What would you say, personally, is the way to go with him? Assuming you're not trying to counter anything, it's just like...
I still think, like, FaZe Mask of Madness is really strong. Like. Mm-hmm. If you have a level 4 bear and you have Phase Mask of Madness, the amount of damage that you actually deal and also the uptime versus how often you would actually entangle is way better. Because for the cost, the attack speed that you get for Mask of Madness, like on demand, is the best, mm-hmm. right? And the bear
Isn't
is still...
Mask of Madness, though, like just kind of a little bit too tower pushy? Like, wouldn't you want Maelstrom to actually be able to...
It's not just about tower push, though. It's about being able to keep the bear on the target, get as many hits as humanly possible off, and secure and entangle.
Possible.
Right. I mean, not everyone's Admiral Bulldog and just gets roots, you know? So you got to have that uptime. But that's just my own personal opinion. I don't play the hero that much.
I played him.
I've seen a lot of people doing it, and it seems pretty strong. Yeah. So.
What did you go for, James?
Well, I went to the little boy's room when we were on picking, and I fortunately randomed in all pick ranked, and I was support Lone Druid.
Support Lone Druid.
I did better than most of my cores. They were fucking awful.
I don't think you won that game.
I reported all. No, I didn't, but it wasn't me, because my support Lone Druid was legit. I was zoning out my lane like a motherfucker.
You got a bear.
Of course, exactly.
You can zone him out.
I was just like, yo, take my Orb of Venom, just hitting him constantly.
Dude, that's so next level. Support Lone Druid.
Lone Druid.
Even if you were against a tri-lane, you just throw your bear at him.
Well, the thing is that if you can play Lone Druid and have the bear support you.
No.
The only annoying thing was I had to run around and ward as well. I was like, ugh. But then I ended up like, you know, you can farm the jungle really nicely when you're...
Really slowly, actually.
Yeah.
He's like the slowest jungler.
Not me. My bear hates...
I get those lone druids who go jungle and they buy 2 Midases.
Yeah.
And then by 15 minutes in, we've lost all our outer 2 towers, and then I'm just like, I hate Dota.
Yeah, man.
When I was playing Dota 1... if you were a Lone Druid and you didn't go to the jungle, you'd get flamed.
That's true.
Yeah. That is a thing. It's like,
getting
come on.
Some nice camera work here from Scriff.
Roshan's pretty
Scriff's
fancy.
Scriff's been on Tinder and he's swiped.
To the right or to the left?
Less
Most of them were to the
girls
right.
Than,
Scriff's standards,
we'll
say, are not high.
Yeah.
but I love him.
By the way, Go, our teal player is back.
Yep. Apparently, he's reconnected to the game, but he hasn't yet taken his hero.
Yeah, he hasn't taken his hero.
Good luck. Have fun.
Who is
you know, I actually wouldn't put it past Team Tinker to maybe try an aggressive lane this game.
Who do we blame? I don't know who we blame.
They could very easily just put the Lone Druid bottom, right, but man, triple range with Viper against Terrorblade, God, that would be a disaster. And even if the Terrorblade goes top, it's not like Koifa would necessarily be that deterred by having a Terrorblade in his lane.
Nope.
Plus one. It's
not a great laner.
I think they are going to go aggressive. Or at the very least, EGM and others are walking down there.
That might be a Panda trailing, but it's pretty interesting. Do you want to introduce the player, Sandy?
No. Okay. James always introduces the players. I don't want to take it away from him.
Okay, James, go ahead. Go wide.
All right, on the Tidehunter, going up against Lone Druid is going to be Ace playing the puck.
Let's keep it clean.
Will
folks.
Be Arias and True. Is that who he is? They're on the Yoga Magi. Come with me on the Visage. And Hanny is going to be farming on the Terrorblade. And then for the side of Team Tinker, we're going to have
Quakefa.
Thank you. On the Lone Druid. EGM, Skyref.
Misery. 30 seconds to
misery.
Time.
Is it misery?
No, that's not misery.
What?
Wait, no, fuck.
Pycat's on the Viper.
Bulba.
Oh, it's Bulba, yeah.
Same.
Pycat on the Viper, and then Singh. Going to be playing Pandaman.
So it looks to be actually
very
a Panda
excited.
Lane, which is interesting. I mean, not to say that Panda's necessarily any worse in terms of lane presence than a Viper, but I figured between the two that you would want to prioritize getting the Brewmaster the levels more than the Viper. Mm-hmm. Because the Viper can shut down the lane
and here we go.
Very hard.
Yeah.
And the Brewmaster will be able to, I would say, accomplish more.
Oh, nice chicken and eye from the Visage.
Yeah, you took the regen. Oh, no, there was a deny one.
Yeah, it was a deny on the bottom. Yeah.
I was watching top.
In the bottom lane, but yeah.
Oh, come with me. Same. I think come with me is like a really, really good player.
Is he gonna get this D ward? No, he doesn't have any D ward.
I think when he performs well, he can outperform almost anybody. But his is like, does he do it every game? No.
Yeah,
really.
I was gonna say he has like a really high variance.
Yeah. Like he's, but I haven't seen him recently as well, so I wonder how much time he's been putting into the game.
Mm-hmm. Well, we see this bottom trailing here, where Sing Sing is gonna get some farm, and the Terrorblade right now is not
yeah,
really
Terrorblades just don't do well in tri-lane, so even if your supports aren't going to be, like, maybe as awesome, but I actually think the supports kind of actually go in favor of Team Tinker here, just because the Skyraf and the Witch Doctor up against an Ogre and a Visage, I think they do a lot more. I think Soul Assumption, though, very strong, doesn't necessarily, it's not a guaranteed amount, like, how much damage you're going to be able to pull out, and, yeah, and you kind of know what the Ogre can do. And the Terrorblade doesn't do anything versus, like, if you get, like, clapped by a Brew as a support here, you're having a bad time. And even EGM is like, look at that damage he puts out to Hanny. Already just one Arcane Bolt, yeah. So...
On the bright side, though, come with me, he did get the D word for the pull camp, yeah. So they will be
See,
able to...
told you, best player in the world.
Would you say this is one of those situations where you just, like, metamorphosis for last hits and try to get...
He has to, pretty much. I mean, this is kind of an oversight from Fnatic in terms of drafting, because they already saw two 600 range supports, one of which being Skyrath, and they picked Ogre Visage. And then as their tri-lane carry, they picked a melee hero. I mean, that to me just seems like they weren't really
the
prepared. But bottom lane, come with me, going to be in some trouble here. Metamorphosis, Popeye, Hani going to town on Sing Sing. First blood going to be going the way of Bulba. No, you don't have to eat a tree anymore. I think you can just walk straight out. He salved. He's going to get chased down by True. Stun up in 1 second.
He can actually go again. Nope.
I don't think
they want to. Too many creeps. Okay, so not a great start here.
Well, what was expected, right? I mean, they jumped on someone, they have a lot of damage, they have a lot of burst.
But I think come with me, like, didn't need to get clapped by any means.
No, I don't know, that was kind of weird positioning,
like,
by him.
Yeah,
like, it felt like he was, like, lagging or something, because he walked into the trees. Like, he didn't walk back, he walked to the right.
I mean, he just wanted to slow and get a couple of last hits to be able to actually, like, give the Brewmaster a hard time. And here we have Ace, actually. He's got himself eight tangos, he's eaten one. He's
such a... kind of like slight insult. It looked like he lagged.
Yeah, but it's true. He walked to the right. There was no reason for him to walk into the trees.
Hopefully he lagged, otherwise it's
like... Well, I'm giving him the benefit of the doubt and saying that it looked like he lagged. Mm-hmm. Maybe he
did.
What
do you do from this situation if you're Fnatic on this lane? It's like Singh's gonna get absolutely everything.
Yeah, I think that's the true reason why they put him down here, because they don't care about the levels, they just care about the blink timing. Because you can go to a lane at any point and soak a couple of waves of EXP and get your level, but if they had put him mid, there's a much better chance that he wouldn't have had as much farm as he has right now up against the puck, and they know that the Viper crushes the puck.
Yeah.
Well, and even though, that being said, Arai's actually doing really well.
He's doing well, but the thing is, it's just going to get worse.
Yeah.
Like, Hi-Cat is good, like, he's already standing aggressive, so the more, you know, levels the Viper's going to get here, even in at the same pace as the puck, it's like the puck does not have a good time, because you're never going to be able to nuke someone down, like a Viper down in just burst from your spells. So even when you exchange in auto attacks on each other,
yeah,
it's just like you are worthless against a Viper in the mid lane. So and the great thing is like that Viper is got, he's never going to get rotated on without, like, he's going to know it. It's so obvious if anyone is going to rotate because they're not in the tri lane anymore. So he should be fine. The puck as well is like, okay, you know, you're not going to have people rotate on you either, but they don't necessarily need to. And as again, like, Arise is going to have a great game to save Illusion. What's happened in this tri lane. Yeah. I think it's already too far gone. Like, I hate to say that, but when you give Team Tinker this kind of lead, I can't see what's going to bring you back, because you now literally are. It was 4 protect 1. Now it's going to be 4 versus 5 when you go to the mid game. Like, what's Hany really going to offer with... How many last hits has Hany got?
9. At 4 minutes.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not great.
I think you mentioned something even bigger than the fact that he's not getting farm is how easy it is to anticipate Fnatic's movement, given the lanes that they have. Since every single matchup is an even distribution of heroes, anytime anybody leaves, it's going to be super obvious. And the biggest one is probably going to be Arise once he starts TPing to gank, like, probably, I would guess, bottom or top, just to try to focus the attention of Team Tinker elsewhere. So maybe Hany can start to get some farm. And bottom lane, we're going to see a stun here onto EGM. He's going to get slowed as well from a Soul Assumption. The Grave Chill. And the Soul Assumption gets the kill.
Behold.
Now Bulba and Singer are going to have to get out. And the damage potential from Fnatic's lane is definitely there. Yeah. It's just a matter of being able to cherry pick opportunities like that, because EGM was kind of far away from everybody else.
Yeah, I think a little bit optimistic to make something happen.
Jump on the other Magi.
I mean, this is like the ideal hero to go on, honestly, if you're Fnatic. He has so much HP. Singh actually taking quite a bit of damage. Grave Chill's there. Come with me. Does not have enough mana for a Soul Assumption, but the auto attacks from Hany proving to be a little bit too strong. Bulba retreating under the tower, and now Hany will also run. I mean, it ended up being a 1-for-1. They did kill the Ogre, but losing Singh is not worth it.
No. But EGM, in terms of like actually just going into the jungle there, that was a little bit too optimistic. But wanted to shut down the farm, but you kind of need the whole team with you. But again, Singh was like very content farming, because it's not so much like stopping the supports from getting a little bit of levels. You just want to stop the Terrorblade. So maybe Team Tinker on a couple of different pages in that first engagement. But and they traded, and it did actually go in Fnatic's favor.
This is one of those things that we talk about. The new patch is like
double damage.
You sometimes don't need to go very aggressive when you're doing well. Singh was doing well there. Like, he was trying to deny farm to the supports, but they were getting whatever they wanted themselves. Just the risk of trading is sometimes not worth it. And they paid for the aggression. Fortunately for them, Pykar is doing great in the mid lane, and in the top lane, the Lone Druid is going to destroy the Tidehunter, which is doubling him in CS right now.
I would actually still argue that Arise is doing way
than I would have anticipated. Like,
I mean, the thing about Puck is you have to play it passively, so you have to, like, ideally not orb for CS, try to just trade auto attacks, and because of the fact that Pycat's going the max corrosive skin build, the more points in the nether toxin you have, more or less the more you dominate the CS, but the less harass you have. And I think he noticed that there weren't that many points into nether toxin given how hard he hits, and he just decided that after orbing like once and saying, oh, he's maxing corrosive, I'll just try to trade normally.
That is actually a great build that most Vipers are doing. And I was talking to Pycat and during the Star Ladder. He said that is the build that you have to go. I'm not sure it's so
setting.
Max corrosive skin. It's like, it is a thing. But, I mean, in the end, it just means that every time that Pack hits orbs or whatever, he will not take any damage. And the damage on Pack will be huge. Here comes the rotation.
Stay near. Here comes the coil. Silence.
And
Hany's
there. No, they should be able to take him down. But
Hany's gonna die though, I think. Viper strike. Yep, gets the kill. Bulba's in range to get some EXP, which is nice. Now he's level 5. But it's not actually going so bad for Fnatic.
They're definitely bringing some game to this. And I honestly felt like that tri lane was just gonna go really bad for him. But EGM was like, nah, guys.
Ace.
We can have some
aggressive there.
He's man fighting a bear. Actually, two bears. I mean, one bear is manly enough, but two bears?
And a watermelon?
EGM looking for, come with me down here. He's gonna get slowed. I don't know if he has enough damage to kill. He's throwing out a few more auto attacks. Here comes the silence and the concussive shot. And now come with me might have overstayed his welcome a little bit too much. Sing with the clap. Soul Assumption almost gets the kill. 23 HP. But not quite.
He had the right idea, and if he had gotten the kill, it would have been worth it. But in the end, it's just 23 HP short. And it's going to be one more kill for Sing Sing, which is in wait for his dagger right now.
And then we have a mid lane swap. Ogre Magi versus Witch Doctor. Pokehead's come back in. Shame.
Lots of pinging going on. But yeah, Sing Sing is going to get really close. He's already level 6, and he's really close to that blink dagger. He's going to have it by before 10 minutes into the game. And unless they stop him right now, he will start roaming. He will start doing whatever he wants and just killing heroes around the map. And most importantly, open up a lane so that maybe either the either one of the supports can get the level 6 faster. And without...
Oh, they see Hani.
That's scary.
He has Sunder, but... I want to say he actually just saw Sing Sing for a little bit of time there. Well, he is farming. Never mind. He didn't see him. There's no way he would stay here if he saw that.
Oh, yeah.
They're going to come in.
This is
The ward on the high ground spotted them. That's how. Yeah. It sees, like, into the path, into the woods. So when they walked over there, they had vision.
Nice catch.
Still, though, stopping Hani from farming. He's at 21 last hits. And, yeah, the Brewmaster of Sing Sing should be able to set the pace of this game, much more so than the Puck. The Puck, in terms of like getting that kill mid, was nice. He's going to have to do it again with the next Dream Coil, which is available. But when that's going to happen, who knows? But here it is. It looks like they're going to smoke and move top, and they want the Lone Druid. And that maybe will give Hani some farm under the mid tower once the creeps push in. So
this is an even harder kill than killing Pycat right now, killing Koika with 1,500 health.
But there is a Ravage.
They need the Terrorblade damage. Like,
don't you think the Ravage and the Dream Coil is enough?
Yeah, yeah.
It's not a matter of them not being able to get it with three. It's that Team Tinker will have ample time to TP to the tower and maybe get counter kills if they try to go for him.
I don't know, man. I think this bear's dead.
Oh, like, I think he might die without
TPs, and they should be able to get out as well. That's a massive. Well,
they're committing quite a bit here. He gets an entangle on Ace. He's still living for a very long time. Quick was going to be able to get here. The Ravage finally expended just to be able to retreat. Sing blinks him. They should be able to get, at the very least, one counter kill. Death Ward is dropped. Bulba gets that kill. EGM getting chased down a bit here by True and Rise. Now going to get ulted by Pycat. And this is kind of what I was saying. It's like,
yeah, exactly.
You're going to die if you commit to the Lone Druid. And they sure as hell do. Trade 2-for-1.
Puck gets out. You called it.
Hey,
I thought they'd be able
money.
To get the kill and get out a lot quicker than that, but Pycat rotates in from the mid lane.
I mean, if he had a casual cloak
even, TP'd.
If Koika even had a casual cloak, he would have lived so much longer. And I don't even know, like, they probably still would have killed him, but I don't know. It's really risky to gank under a tier 1 against a hero that has that much HP.
So if you're Sing Sing now, is it basically, do you want to hunt down the Terrorblade and use your ultimate on him?
I think so. He's going for it right now. He did get the clap on Hani. Rise is going to
have mana for. Oh, he didn't have mana for ult.
Yeah, he doesn't have any stat.
Here's what's happened in the Dire's bottom tower.
Otherwise, he would have gone for the Terrorblade straight away.
It's the Mask of Madness bear. Yeah.
Just munching the tower.
Oh, no.
And I know there's no Ravage, so it's like pretty much a free tier 1. I don't really see Fnatic being able to defend this without Coil, without Ravage. Coil's up in 5, though.
Sunny's actually stayed in the fight here. Oh, we actually get a Sunder on the Lone Druid.
Oh, that's really big.
They'll take it down, and they do get the kill. Bruce plays use. They go for a Rise, since he's chosen that target. He's going to get his Fire Panda actually stunned out there, and just going to put the Terror Blade up. But they get the tower, they lose one, they pop the Brewmaster ultimate, and then they back off. So, not amazing for Team Tinker, but certainly Objective Gaming, they get it. And they're going to have to defend here, the mid tower.
The thing is that Terrorblade is not dying right now anymore. And he was there involved in the kill. He's going to get some more farm. And I think the game goes faster later and later. And this guy will get scary. Jesus.
His recovery is actually fairly good, even just sitting inside of the jungle, too. Like, if you have Quelling Blade, Treads, Aquila, Poor Man's, you have 15 armor
towers in bad level 8 shape.
With all these items, so he's pretty much good to sit here as long as he wants. They do have one like semi-aggressive ward that sees the bottom rune and sees a bit into the jungle, but you can see the warding right now from Fnatic 2. They really want to protect their side of the map. A ward mid, a ward right by the bottom rune spot. EGM could potentially get soloed here by Come With Me. One teleport coming in. It's going to be Pycat, but I think EGM should drop here. Oh, the mech timing. Come With Me wants to try to TP out. Actually cancels his own TP to try to go for the counter kill, but doesn't get experience. Not sure if that was really worth it, especially giving the kill to Pycat.
Well, he was dead already, and I don't think...
No, he would have gotten out.
You think the TP would have...
Yeah, he definitely would have lived, but... Come
with me, man.
The cancel for greed. Cancel for greed. They want to try to hunt down this bear again, but that's not really what you want. He got entangled. He just stuns, TPs. Should be okay. Yeah, Bulba was almost in range for a cask, but not quite.
The Dire might want to mine the top tower. The Tidehunter, and we've also once again got our Dream Coil.
This is
big. And we've got the birds and the medallion up for Come With Me's Visage. So they can definitely put out some significant damage in these team fights now. Just whether or not they can take them on their terms, and or if they can catch anybody out. And Bulba not going to be the best target to take down if they do manage to find him. On the bottom lane, we do have Pycat, which could be a much more tastier kill if you want to be able to pick him up. He does have that mech.
Radiant's top tower's hurting.
This is also the time where Team Tinker starts pushing towers aggressively. They have the Mask of Madness on long.
I think it's dangerous.
They have a mech on the Viper.
It is a bit dangerous, but Fnatic have to drop basically everything on one hero to kill it. That's the problem, is they don't have a tremendous amount of AoE. True's going to get caught out again here inside of the river. Viper Strike is there.
Somebody's on a roll.
They're even going to drop the Mystic Flare on it. Pycat hits that kill.
Double damage.
And he's actually opted not to get a bottle, which I find a little bit interesting, given the fact that, obviously, the increase to mana cost on mech lead me to believe that you would always want to get it. Come with me. It's going to get solo split and clapped down here by Sing. Teleport reaction coming in from Arise gets immediately thrown up into the air. A Familiar trying to kill the Fire Spirit as hard as it pretty much can right now. Hani also in the action trying to save. Come with me.
He only has
the Air Spirit out here. Auto attack from a double damage pike. That will secure that kill. Teleport reaction coming in from the Tide. Ace looking for a Ravage. Blinks forward. Hits on three, actually. Sing going to get coiled near the tower as well. Should be the first one to fall here. Hani gets that kill. Ace continually chasing here. Death Ward and the cast both onto Ace. Bulba now dominating. No multicast. One more auto attack from Hani. Not quite enough. Pycat pops the mech to keep Bulba alive. And that should be it.
They waited until the bird drop, and then that was the signal for Bulba to drop the ultimate. Gets the Brewmaster, there's no, the Tidehunter, and it's all over from there.
But it's still not a horrible trade. Like, that was on Team Tinker's terms, right? So they were like, we start the fight and we do what we want. And the interesting thing about that was, is like, okay, we can see how much damage Fnatic are able to put out with their lineup, as they do actually get a bear kill on Come With Me, 300, and almost picked up Koikfa as he left on like 260 health. But the point is Team Tinker took that on their terms. It went okay, but not great. And Fnatic, if they actually get to take fights on their terms, the Tide and also
Radiant's bottom tower
could be devastating. But we really have to see if it's going to be the case later on in the game, because they have bought Terrorblade a decent
Radiant's
amount of time.
It's not tower in a pretty sight right
it's
now.
It's not overly
Radiant's
concerning
toughened up
yet
their structures.
For Fnatic, which is impressive. I like the way they've recovered, but they really
Trouble
need to
brewing at Radiant's bottom tower. Yeah. Radiant's
take
bottom
things on
tower.
Their terms.
It would be really nice if they can take one or two towers as well, because Team Tinker right now is pushing and they're slowly getting their objectives going.
You need the Terrorblade to go out and be able to hit a tower, and for that to happen, you need a pick.
Yeah.
And you need a pick where the cooldown, you know, gives you time. So it's like the puck, and the puck needs to make that happen. And the Tidehunter ulti is a little bit, you know, a longer cooldown, obviously, so it's not going to be so easy to make that those plays on the Tide. So it's tough right now for Fnatic. But I really like that Pycat does this on his Viper. He always goes Ags first before BKB, and I think it's well worth it pretty much most of the time. I think getting the BKB a little bit later actually offers more in the later team fights with that 10-second immunity, because the burst damage, you know, increases from the enemy spells. And I think that the Aghanim's just offers a lot of durability.
So, yeah, that does for sure. They're going to try to counter push a tier one here. I think Fnatic had a pretty good idea that Team Taker is doing Roshan, but they don't really want to try to contest with that Ravage ship. Koikfa's going to get his hand on an Aegis. And I like the fact that they actually gave it to him, because I don't really think they want to focus Pycat. Pycat is such a hard target to actually take down in these engagements. I mean, ideally you want to kill Sing before he splits, or maybe even pick off the supports a little bit earlier on to the engagement. And with a good Ravage, you can probably get away with doing that.
Well, Ravage is available now, so whatever happens with this next teamfight, unless they get jumped on, it can be on Fnatic's turn. We'll see what happens. Ace is waiting there, now he reveals himself. Apparently Team Tinker does not want to engage.
Yeah, they only have one ward, and they can't really see much else. I mean, both their wards have a pretty limited line of sight that's down right now, whereas Fnatic, they have one defensive ward bottom, and then they have a high ground ward right outside of the enemy woods. So both teams actually kind of not the greatest vision right now, all over the map.
Dire's top tower, you know the drill.
He's looking to defend middle, but They've been farming all lanes currently since that tier 1 tower went down to Tinker, so they're still staying ahead of the gold. They'll probably want to come back and defend this, but they are aware that the Ravage is available.
The jump from the Rule Master pops the ultimate. Honey will be able to live.
He's going to have another boulder in about 1 second.
It's dangerous. Like, once that brew spin is over, we might see the Ravage come out. Actually, the Tide's going to be put in the air. Arise is going to be taken out by EGM. Nicely down there. And we need this Tide to get involved and throw down that Ravage, but I think it's a little bit too late. They're going to have to bail, and they do bail. Ace is just going to blink up and TP away, and they're going to give away too. And Hani went middle, I think, or was it no? Come with me is currently middle. They lost the bottom tier 2 tower as well. So, and Hani's actually only just started farming the bottom lane. So, I mean, come on, if you're going to fight, you're going to fight. If you're gonna, like, the odd thing is like before that fight happened, 3 people were moving across the top lane towards the tower. And then the Tide was actually kind of backing off Ace, and he wasn't really in position. He was all the way on the far left of the jungle dire jungle, and then he decided, okay, no, we are going to do something, and then no. But they could have actually just disengaged and not done anything with the tier 2 tower. Like, the damage doesn't mean anything. You might as well just rotate it and maybe try and get a pick on someone actually pushing out your lanes, because there were 2. There was 1 bottom and there was 1 mid. So Fnatic a little bit undecided on what they want to do, not fully committing, and they lose 2 because of it, and they lose a tower, and we have an Aghanim set to happen, the Bulba now. So
the Bulba.
The Bulba.
Wow.
He's gone from Bulba to the Bulba. But I think they kind of just weren't on the same page for the fight because they saw Roshan die. And then I'm pretty sure a few of them said, let's try to take the fight. And then the two other people said, no, we don't want to take this fight. And then they decided to run, which I agree with the choice to run. Because if you have Terror Blade, and Hani is actually recovering quite nicely. He's second highest, in, at least in terms of CS, but his net worth is the 3rd highest in the game right now. If you're able to get up like 1 or 2 items, your fighting potential goes through the roof. Like, that hero scales phenomenally, of
How
course.
Does the Witch Doctor have so much gold?
The Dire he's on top.
Dude, he's got 4 kills. And they've killed,
Radiant's mid tower.
What, 4 towers and Roshan?
Yeah, but like he has more gold than Sinxin that has been farming the safe lane.
Have fun trying to bust down Radiant structures now. Radiant's mid tower.
He's been in the kills. 6.8
UC. Here comes a rabbit. That's a pop on the Doctor.
And hits on 2 and a bear. They're really going hard on this bear. Death Ward's going to just be used. And look at it bouncing between everyone on the side of Fnatic. Hani actually just dies to Pycat, but majority of the damage that was dealt there definitely through that Death Ward. Now chasing down to True. Bulba has another stun here in about 1 second. How long in the concussive? 5. They're not going to be able to get that kill. Come with me. Getting a little too big for his bridges here. Seven just going to get slapped down by Pycat as well. Tier 2 should die here. No problem. They might even be able to apply some pressure to the Tier 3. Well, it's only 30 seconds.
Yeah,
but they know there's no Ravage. They know there's no Coil.
No, you're
and
good.
Sing actually has split.
How many points in Voodoo Restoration does the Witch Doctor have?
3 points.
Yeah.
He's actually stopped at 3 and got stats, I think. Right? Yeah, he did.
Radiance. Oh, you were talking about these teams trying to go high ground 25 minutes Radiance into the game. It's 21, and here we are. First melee Rax is going to fall. They can keep going bottom, but they can't keep going top because there's no lane. I think they go back.
Yeah, the biggest problem was that when Fnatic actually were dangerous, they weren't able to coordinate where and why they were fighting. So the bottom fight was on Team Tinker's terms. The top fight over the Tier 2 tower, half the team seemed like they wanted to, half the team seemed like they didn't. Come With Me wasn't there, just as birds, and it all went pretty downhill. So. Even with the amount of damage they're pushing out, we've got an Aegis still on the bear, and Pycat, though, taking a lot of damage, should be okay.
There is Witch Doctor ulti again, if they want to go.
Yep.
Look at follow up there.
Needs to get his ulti off next,
we're going to see everything. Yeah, Sing just dies here. EGM going for the kill on Come With Me. We'll be able to secure it, but Arise actually gets a kill on Sing and EGM. Now Koikla, Bulba, and Pycat all going to be forced to retreat. No Ravage still for about 44 seconds, but they got the racks.
Yeah.
There's not really any problem, I think, with Team Tinker losing 2 there, even though Sing didn't end up using his split. But the problem with Fnatic is the Terror Blade needed too many items, I think. And between a Puck and a Tide, sure, you have a lot of lockdown, but the only damage really on your team outside of a multicast is Hani. Or Come With Me, maybe getting a good soul assumption and a couple of familiars on somebody, which is good damage. Like, they had everything, I think, that they needed to be able to kill one person. But after that, they have no follow-up. Like, they can kill one person. And then the team fight is like over
could use a little
I feel like in drawn out team fights, you have Viper, you have Skywrath, who can consistently do
Look at Pycat with a blink, finds Honey.
I mean, he still has Sunder. He doesn't have a TP, though. Ace is going to throw out a Gush. Same comes here. Death Ward. It's over.
Like, even if you got the Manta style a little bit earlier on Hany, the fact that Bulba's been able to pick up an Aghanim's, it's like, with a Manta style, you can probably fight through a lot of the, you know, what's in front of you in terms of just, like, you can kill the bear, you'd probably be able to kill the panda and split. You know, you can do a lot of damage in those team fights if you're able to just not get smacked down. And even, you know, versus a Skyref, you'd probably still be okay. But then you bring out a Death Ward with Aghanim, it's like you can't do anything now as a Terrorblade. Like, you're meant to be able to stand there and fight. And if people aren't cancelling the Death Wards in the team fights, you're having a bad time. And we said it in the middle fight, like, you know, Ravage was used, didn't hit the Witch Doctor, so Bulba was like, okay, Death Ward. Ended up killing Hany plus another one, I believe. But it's like the Visage Birds weren't actually attacking him. Come With Me was just going for damage. So it's almost like now you've got three cores plus a Witch Doctor that's actually the fourth core that you have to deal with. And the Manta's up on Terrorblade. I don't think they can deal with this.
I mean, at this point, Team Tinker can't even afford to go into a really bad team fight just to force to pop the Ravage and the Dream Core.
Sing Sing can just dive in and just go ham and actually just buy enough time for people to actually get damage either on the tower and then just back off if they want to, with just a Death Ward at the end of it, you know, and like kind of almost force the Ravage out with how you want to take the tower. So it's...
How do you feel about Split pushing with a bare bottom and keeping the rest of the team up top?
I think two supports could actually probably just deal with the bear. But Come With Me has been very diligent about always, like, Medallion, put the familiars in the bear. Soul Assumption, because Koifa always pops his Mask of Madness to hit the tower to make sure that the maximum, you know, chip damage is done. But I think you can kind of deal with split push, maybe okay, not great. That's another thing, too, that the problem with Fnatic actually has, is that their wave clear is not very good.
No.
They have Anchor Smash, and they have Puck.
Yeah.
That's it. I mean, familiars push out the lane a little, but they're not the best because they eventually run out of damage and then you have to drop them to make sure that they actually continue to deal damage. So I think in a lot of ways, like, Fnatic just got outdrafted.
Yeah.
We saw the bottom lane, and even though they got a couple of trade kills, that was pretty much only due to the fact that EGM was a bit out of position one time. I mean, that's pretty much the only time they traded. And they decided to go on an Ogre of all the heroes in the lane. So.
Yeah.
I think if they had just played the typical War of Attrition lane and just let you passively farm, Sing would have had a much faster blink,
and
more
no
than likely.
Died.
And they started off with a first blood and, like, didn't trade anything for it. They just got a kill. So.
Bulba doesn't know what to go for now. He has Ogre Axe, he has half a Shadow Blade.
He's very confused. He's never had this much gold in the history of his competitive career.
He is insanely
career.
Farmed, though. He's fourth highest on net worth.
Yeah. That
right.
is why I actually
let's see if this Ravage defense
Dire's top
will be
tower,
enough
you know the drill.
For Fnatic to hold.
I'm actually surprised that they don't decide to push the issue. But I think they want to go for Roshan. Pike gets to the
gonna be
by himself.
In like very soon?
10 seconds?
Is it the 8 minute timer or the other timer? Yeah, it's right there. Okay.
Do we have a cloak on the lone druid yet?
Nope.
Yeah. That would have been such a good item versus that pack, and also a Ravage.
It's a really good value item because he has such a high amount of base health. It's always good to get. He could also, if he wants to, I guess, go Vlad's, but no, Sing has Vlad's, never mind.
That is fine. Now this is going to be a last Rosh, and with the Rosh and the Lone Druid, they can clearly go high ground from the bottom, take that tower, and once that tower is down, pretty much nothing that's going to allow Fnatic to defend. When you have only one line of Rax lost, you have Terror's Blade, you will not get as much farm because you will be killing those creeps, but at least you will be able to control it with not much problem. Unfortunately, past that, with only two, as we said before, not much wave clear, it's going to be very, very one-sided from the moment.
So who do you think Fnatic have told to handle this Witch Doctor for the next team fight? Because they have to be aware that that Witch Doctor will win them any team fight if not interrupted, right? Because once the fight has started, you know, your Tide goes in, your Puck has to go in to do damage. You have to cast spells on top of people to do damage with those two heroes.
I think they're going to leave it to familiars, honestly.
Yeah, it has to be, yeah. So you think it's, familiars?
Yeah.
All right, and then Come With Me has, he's almost got his Axe, actually has now completed it. So he's got three birds, he's got three stuns. We'll see how well Come With Me is going to be able to handle this, but it's maybe a little bit too much to ask of him going into the final team fight, but that's almost what it's going to come
really
down
that
to.
It's not really that hard, though. I mean, you basically Grave Chill, right, and then you Soul Assumption, and you have your bird stop one person.
Yeah.
So I think he can do it. It's not necessarily that hard. The other option is having the Tidehunter be the one who goes in first, because they need the stun to stop damage. Like, Puck Coil is a mini stun, and nobody cares about Puck Coil on Team Tinker because they're all so overfarmed. So I think the Tide would have to go just to be able to stun, and then the Puck waits for the... He's gonna get Yulest here. They're taking a lot of damage from that bear. They need to be careful. He still has an Aegis as well. Come with me, gonna be chasing him with the familiars. He's gonna run right into Ace. The rest of Team Tinker is coming in here. EGM gonna throw out a silence onto the Tidehunter, who does have Ravage. He'll be able to use it soon. The Mystic Flare again, way off by EGM. And Koikva trying to put himself back into ult form. Probably gonna be dropping here. Coil hits on two. Bulba keeping him alive a little bit longer with the Voodoo Restoration. Now also in some trouble himself. He's gonna pop the Shadow Amulet. And he's more than fine in the meantime. EGM finishing off Ace. And he just drops the Death Ward and kills Come With Me. The cast bounces between the familiars, but doesn't stun. Yeah. So it wasn't great, but Arise does manage to kill.
Recap for a second, see.
Nicely done, though. Picking up the Lone Druid twice.
Yeah, they got ahead just because...
Yeah, Fnatic actually won that fight in
terms of
experience.
Look at that, Puck got 1,700 gold and 3,000 experience.
Not bad. I mean, but if he didn't have a Hex, he's going to have one soon. And Pycat's just inside of the base, casually killing people. Yeah, has BKB blink.
Okay, now he gets stunned.
Yeah, those birds play no games, by the way. He's going to get Yulest here. Cancels the blink. The birds are going to be up in a second. Hani looking for a reflection. We'll be able to get it out to Pycat.
There's no metamorphosis, so it's just walking illusions. It's going to be okay, and those birds have to run. Things in chasing birds.
TP's coming in.
Oh, finally. Ravage
gonna hit on two. Silence actually only hits on one. Doesn't decide to go for the double onto EGM. Sing gonna try to TP out here. Doesn't manage to do so. Hani trying to chase down EGM, gonna earn himself up a bit. He still has a gem. He's gonna go for the TP, but they had a ward in the high ground, so the Yules is gonna come through from the rise. And that's gonna be a kill for him.
The comeback is real.
They defended pretty well, to be honest. I mean, they lost a tier three, but.
No. I mean, it was the first time they took a fight on their terms. They got the initiation. You know, even through an Aegis, they were actually able to get the kill. But, like, of course, that wasn't really a fight that you're expecting Team Tinker to say, like, oh, that was a team fight we were ready for, because the rotations were, you know, they came in, they were slow. Yes, the gem is on the ground, as we can see. Thank you, Skriff. He's obsessed with that gem. Skriff loves
shiny things. I said he had a gem. I thought it was... You know, by powers of deduction, you could say that the thing was dropped.
Oh, yes.
It's a courier's
thing.
1,750.
That was a voice stone or something else, I guess.
You should be able to click on that thing and
see what's...
A coin of the realm. Yeah.
But either way, it was the first fight that Fnatic took on their terms. Team Keeper allied position. They actually went through the Aegis, killed it again, and even took down Bulba at the end, so... The trade wasn't in their favor so much, but as you said, the gold was. So Ryze, yeah, putting some pressure onto the Lone Druid. I think the gem is actually all being picked up by now, surely. I think someone's walked up.
No. I think Ogre, no?
It's just sitting there. The funny thing is they have a ward too. So they can actually see it just sitting there. They're baiting it.
So shiny.
They're assuming that somehow Tinker has vision over there, which, by the way, Tinker doesn't have a single ward on the map right now.
But who needs wards when you have kills and gold?
That's true, but...
You think Pycat's troll blink dagger, he'll ever regret it?
It's not a troll, it's good. That I mean, think about their chasing potential right now. They basically only have one hero. Solo killed them. But they only have one hero who really can chase, and that's Sing. And also, because he has BKB, the physical damage on Hani isn't high enough to really threaten him at this point, because all he has is a Manta and an Ultimate Orb. If he wants to blink in the base with a BKB and ult somebody to prevent, like, Tide Ravage, that's legit. Like, you can't blink and ravage like four people. It's not bad.
Yeah, this mad bear.
I think if we look at statistics, though, Andy, for how many...
obviously not a common item. I'm just saying I think it's good.
Hey, I don't disapprove. When you're ahead, you know, it gives you an advantage. But, you know, it's almost like, you know, do you really need it? I mean, could you have just, like, picked up something that helped you actually... put even more pressure down onto towers, and we can see Team Tinker here looking to Sing from Arise. Split is now available. He actually gets Yule up in the air. Come with me out of position. Going to get bursted down. There is the support, but there is a buyback, and Hani is split pushing top. So they're going to have to fight with Adam. Cliff is used, and they're actually going to TP back Piker. And he's looking to put some pressure, and they're just going to disengage for the moment. So, looking at the top fight.
Fnatic actually getting a lot out of this.
Well, they're going to get a range rack, so I don't know if that's necessarily a lot. Hani going to go for the TP out here. Yule's going to be popped straight away, and a Mystic Flare.
Oops, that's a lot of damage.
Yeah, he's not really having the greatest of times right now. EGM gonna be forced to run away. There's
the mech. It's gonna be fine. With
us. Bottom lane in the meantime. Orion's done up here by a boulder toss. We are trying to get out here. Soul Assumption's coming through. Coil gonna land on two. Ravage to follow it up. Death Ward being channeled. Arise, unfortunately, can't live through the damage. Sing actually manning down, not going for the kill on Ace. He's gonna be dropping. Come with me, picking up the double. Now Bulba throwing out one more cask, realizing he might have made a horrible mistake. And here comes the Shadow Amulet once again.
You can't see him.
Just sitting there.
Oh my god. He's playing with
is this real life?
Like, he's regening in the meantime.
Is this actually happening right now?
Yep.
Is a Shadow Amulet going to. He's gonna TP! They can't stop him! They don't have any birds! Oh my god.
And he buys a BKB on top of that.
XD. That is the appropriate response after you get away like that.
Yep.
You type XD.
What a clown. Can you show me the gem still on the ground, just for the sake of it?
No, it's gone.
It went to the ogre, right? And then got picked up in the jungle when he was trying to deward. Yep. I think the ogre had it and then dropped it, and then EGM picked it up. Because he died in the jungle when it was dewarded.
Yeah, he was caught by the laundry.
All right, Bulba. He's making plays. Two lanes of racks down. They got a range racks though, Fnatic. And they still fight from behind. And they still wish this game started a little bit better. Because they've certainly got game to them. Like, this is the thing, like, even though, like, you say, like, Fnatic is, you knew them before, you know, a lot of people's favorite team. I think some of the members they got come with me arise really, really good, like really solid. So it's nice that they're still playing this one out, not giving up, want to take the team fights to the.
I mean, they got a hex on Arise. Hang on to that
mid tower. Yeah, he's actually the most farm hero on their side, even above the Terrorblade. But then again, 12,000 gold doesn't mean much when the Viper has 19,000.
Well, we also have to remember that he was the one in those kills in the bottom lane where he basically got like 4,000 gold in, what, two fights?
Pretty much.
I mean, that's a lot for two fights. He went from having basically a Yules and a Blank Dagger to a full Hex. I don't know.
Who'd you Hex?
Probably Sing. Okay. I mean, Hexing anything else just kind of feels like a waste.
Nice. I think Sing's very burstable as well.
Yeah, I think you always Hex Sing. I mean, the last time, Arise was able to get a good silence off before the split, so if you imagine a Hex on top of a silence and Sing doesn't have a BKB, then that means that there's basically no way he should split. And the thing is, Team Tinker don't have really great counter-initiation. They just have an initiator.
There's a refresher on Tide.
Okay, second question.
How much gold did you get in that last fight?
How do you stop Witch Doctor from BKB ulti?
You refresher. You can't. Yeah. You don't.
You don't.
Oh, come with me. Gonna eat an ult here. Blink forward. An immediate ult coming out from Sing. This is most likely just for zoning purposes. He's gonna throw True up in the air. Arise goes in. One Ravage gonna be expended. Hits on three. The second Ravage comes out, but the Death Ward dealing quite a bit of damage here. Ace gonna end up falling. Now, Quakefoot quite low on health as well. Bulba actually getting the double as True also drops. Hani not gonna be able to get asunder. Sing blinks away before he's able to cast it. And this should be the second set of racks. Maybe even potentially a GG since bottom racks are naked, but they're not really pushing that hard. Quakefoot's had to back up. The bear's not even inside of the base right now. The bird's doing some damage here to Sing. The Hex onto Sing as well. Coconut comes out, does one stun. Yeah, he does the phase shift. Sing ends up dropping here. He's gonna buy back, teleports to the mid tier two. Bear also gonna go down. One more soul assumption. They get that. They defend the racks. Pycat's still around, but I don't know about this, actually. He throws out one ultimate onto True. Come with me, get to eat the Mystic Flare. So much damage coming out from EGM. Okay, yeah, they're gonna get both. Underestimating the Skywrath damage is bad. The Skywrath does lots of damage.
He really does, and he's level 16, hasn't skill level 3 ultimate yet, but probably has a point there. Oh, yeah, there he is.
Yeah, he just leveled, I think, off
the rest. So, to answer your question, Bruno, you don't stop the Death Ward with the BKB.
You really don't.
Rise. Double silence. Orbs away. Just imagine if he had a Dag in 5 right there, dude. Free kills.
GG, sis. Honey?
Wasn't an overly bad performance, though, from Fnatic, I have to say.
Well, they had to play from behind, basically, the whole game.
Yeah. But it's nice, because
he was just BKB'd and Yules at the same time.
It's scary.
That's weird.
It is.
I also had somebody purge Yules off me yesterday.
Is that a thing?
Yeah! I got purge and Yules, like, at pretty much the same time. Like, I Yules myself and got defused. And I came back down straight away, and I was like,
wait a minute.
What just happened? That was so bizarre.
You can only do it at the beginning.
Yeah. He did it like right at the start.
Jesus.
So I Yules like a split second after, and I just came down.
Oh, well played, Team Tinker. Yeah. They take the game one.
Well drafted.
Felt like a very casual game to me. Maybe it was our commentary, but I was just kind of watching it, going, oh yeah. They're ahead.
The thing is, they were ahead the whole game.
There was nothing on the line.
Yeah.
It was just like, worst thing that could happen. As I said, at some point they could have even just like lost the team fight for the purpose of burning Dream Coil and Ravage. And then they just go high ground and win because there's nothing else from Fnatic.
The biggest issue was when they were drafting, they see Skywrath and Witch Doctor and Viper. And they have Visage and Ogre. Now, I'm not saying Visage and Ogre are weak supports by any stretch, but it feels like they were so confident that they were not going to go aggressive that they could get away with picking a laning Terrorblade. And if Terrorblade gets to level 3 and the rest of the supports gets to level 3, then maybe, you know, you can trade, you know, because Terrorblade does a lot of damage. But
what would you have picked other than Terrorblade? Maybe the Drow Ranger?
Anything with range, like Drow would have been good, obviously, because it gives you the advantage in your puck in middle lane against the Viper. Mm-hmm. Well, maybe not an advantage, but it gives you a little bit of a benefit, mm-hmm. right? And obviously, Orb Auto Attack against any melee farming hero is going to be strong. And they still wanted to put the Viper versus the puck because the Viper should potentially beat the puck, even though it was still really close. So I think that could have been okay. Like even
I think Drow serves a similar purpose as well. Because of Terror. It's like you can still push out lanes very quickly if you want to, and you know you can handle yourself and you can play around the Drow. And in the team fights, you just want to put down a lot of damage. And you can't really choose your targets as a Terrorblade in those team fights. And it's the same with the Drow. You don't really get to choose your target. It's like, who's available? Okay.
But the Drow picks earlier, which you actually would have been beneficial because
in the laning phase as well, man. Like exactly. The Drow doesn't, like, I'm okay with a Drow doesn't get like a huge amount of level advantage, for example, like over a Viper, etc. But I'm just happier if my Drow gets last hits.
Yeah.
Like, because that's important because like that Visage would have been scarier in the lane as well, in terms of, you know, everyone would have been. So.
Their burst would have been insane, actually, like with mm-hmm. Visage Birds and then, the Drow.
And that was the last pick, wasn't it? It was Terrorblade last pick.
It was fourth or fifth, but I know for a fact.
I think it was their fifth.
It was the last pick. Yeah.
And then the last pick came afterwards for the. Lone Druid was the last.
Yeah, that was the last pick. Yeah.
Maybe they would have changed something up.
Maybe. Anyways, we're going to go to a break right now. And when we come back, we'll get game 2 between Team Tinker and Fnatic.
I'm excited.
I am as well. Are you excited?
Yes.
Cool. Mm. 3 excited people, mm. 1 desk. See you in a bit.
Why is no one sitting close to me in my previous screen?
I need to go to the bathroom.